So, because we literally just finished playing episode 2, I'm not going to waste any more time with any recapping. Let's just do this thing. Also, what the hell? This wasn't here a second ago. You know what? I'm not even going to question it. Just go. Just play the game. Just play the game. Just play. Hit play. Long road ahead. Everybody get the popcorn ready. Please don't crash. I beg you, please don't crash or do anything stupid.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
You've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters, and you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
Those look like the people who raided my
camp.
Calm
down, you're paranoid.
Fuck you!
Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
That's right. I know who you are, and I know you're a killer.
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it! What the fuck?
It's like a car.
It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
We have to take this, Clementine. We need it to survive.
Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe.
I still wince whenever I see that scene of that salt lick coming down on Larry's head. Like, that's still a fucked up way to go. Like, the only consolation I have is the fact that he didn't feel anything. But, holy shit. Like, I'm really not squeamish, but certain things I just can't handle watching. Like, when I did the first part of episode 2, like the incident with David and chopping off his leg, like, that wasn't fun. That wasn't fun to do at all. So let's see how different this section plays out, because I got a feeling Kenny won't be as nasty to me in this sequence as he was when I sided with Lily in the last two times I played this.
Looks like this is our lucky day.
Maybe. They tend to take us by surprise.
Yeah, well, the less I see, the happier I am.
I'm from New York City. What about you guys? Oh yeah, that's right, he got shot.
You made up your mind yet?
About what?
When it comes to the getting the hell out of Macon. I bet you're in the let's stay put camp, considering I've been pushing everyone to leave.
Actually, how long has it been since the events of episode 2? That's a good question. Also, why do I keep doing that?
We should go. Motel's run its course, and it's not safe.
Well, if that's what you think, you should probably fucking speak up. Lily's dug in.
Okay, cool.
Okay, just like last time. Over the rig, into the pharmacy, and scrape together whatever supplies are left.
We didn't leave much in there.
Hey, we're out of options. Something's better than nothing.
So it's about mid, late afternoon over there, right? In the UK?
Shit.
You okay?
The ladder's come loose. I'm not sure how many more trips she's got in her.
I'm not sure how many more trips we've got in us.
No kidding.
Yeah, he's definitely not as nasty to me as he would have been if I had sided with Lily. So this should definitely make things interesting going forward. Like, I don't literally remember everything that we have to do in the future episodes, but I know at least this is going to help to some extent with talking with Kenny. Now, don't get me wrong, Kenny can be an asshole just as much as Lily and Larry, but I don't know, like, he's kind of impulsive. Like, he thinks a lot with his heart, which is not a bad thing in this type of scenario, but sometimes he doesn't think about things rationally, if that makes sense. You know, like, Lily was the more rational one of the group. Lily was the more emotional one. And sometimes those sides conflict. And ironically, in the last episode, one could say that Kenny was being the rational one and Lily was being the emotional one. So that's kind of ironic. They were still on different spectrums of the scale, so to speak. Also, I forgot I have to do this. Sitting here talking. Sorry, guys.
Looks like she's had it.
What now?
I'll find another way up.
I better get a move on.
Alright. So yeah, this place completely went to shit over the last 3 months. I know, like, when we first left, this wasn't like that. So I remember in the first episode we heard, like, military fire and whatnot going on, so this place is like a war zone, literally. Now there's a fucking plane in my parents' pharmacy, so yeah, good time. Also, can I? I'm assuming I have to climb up on top of this. No? Something. Why do I feel like it's something with this vehicle? Okay.
Lily's not doing so good, huh?
Well, I'm not gonna say number one. I helped, too.
It's not good. I'm worried.
No shit. There's a lot to be worried about. She's gonna snap.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. What about you, Spa, or Sparkle? I saw your name when I went to pause the stream for a bit. It's weird. On my screen, like, the font is much darker, so it was kind of hard for me to make out what your name was in its entirety. So I see that it's actually Sparkle Owl, but do you prefer if I call you that, or Spa, or what? How do I? Wait, I thought you turned the winch on from here. Hold on, what am I doing wrong here? I hooked it up to this thing. Right, okay, so now let me walk back over here. Is this thing glitching on me again? Oh, it's over here. Doi! It's just weird that, whatever. Just do it.
The girl's still upset with you for agreeing to take that stuff from the station wagon?
I think she understands.
Hope so. Not like we had much choice.
Right.
Actually, you know what? Now that I'm thinking about this, I think in a previous play, I think when I talked to Kenny, like at one point when I'm talking to Kenny here, he mentioned something about it's been a week. So I think episode 3 takes place about a week after episode 2, roughly. Which, if you think about it, that's kind of crazy that everything's kind of went to shit in just a week's time, but whatever.
Duck was asking about that guy at Herschel's farm last night.
Really? I wasn't sure it fazed him.
Of course it did.
Well,
it was a scary situation for Sean dying and all.
I'm just worried he'll always think it was his fault.
Well, to some extent, it kind of was. If he hadn't turned the thing on, it would have run over Sean's leg and he wouldn't have been stuck when the walker
sure
came.
You're up for this.
Lee, I'm fine. I've got this. Give me your hand.
Shit! What are you doing? You got shot on the other side, didn't you? You got shot on your right side. You're holding your left side. Or am I...
Nice one. Next time I'm bringing Ben. Help me get out.
Seriously, what the hell was she thinking, screaming like this?
What the hell is that? A walker?
Walkers don't scream, do they?
Jesus, I don't think so.
Like, not to be funny, was she on drugs or something? Like, who in their right mind?
It's a girl. She's gonna get us killed.
No shit.
Like, who in their right mind would be screaming to Well, she's fucked.
Fuck. Gotta shoot her. Put her out of this misery.
I don't know we're here.
What do you mean?
I mean, we leave her alive, and she draws them all to her, buying us time.
Yeah.
Think about it. We're always worrying about the ones we can't see. She stays alive and brings them all out of their holes.
All right, here's a decision where I might shoot or leave her be. Well, as stupid as she's being right now, I don't think she deserves to... Okay, just... Sorry, Kenny, but this... Kenny, I know your line of thinking made a lot of sense, but I couldn't do it.
Let's move.
Shit, I hope that doesn't mess me up in the pharmacy now. I mean, I know we're gonna have less time to get stuff, but I hope he's not gonna be an ass to me now, just because of that. Like, that was a bit...
Incoming! Come on, Lee!
Okay, I'm coming.
It's sturdy as hell, but we ain't got much time. Get everything you can out of these racks. Don't forget underneath the counter this time. I'll clear down here and then we gotta go.
Alright, I gotcha, man. I gotcha. Rap shit. Yeah, I think one time I accidentally shot her and I was so mortified. Like, I was like, no. But we definitely have less time to grab things here. So, the answer's. Go! Don't stand there! So, I'm definitely not gonna be able to get everything. But as much logic as Kenny was making in keeping the girl alive so that they would just attract more, she would attract all the walkers, that would have been a pretty messed up way to go. Like, letting someone get eaten alive. Okay, go. Okay, let me see. Is he gonna help me, or is he going to just stand there this time? Are you fucking serious? Wow! So the fact that I didn't shoot the girl that time...
Fridge.
Holy shit. Okay, so now I know. I gotta... Ugh.
Let's fucking get out!
I don't believe this guy. Go. Holy shit, I figured that because I helped him in the meat locker last episode, he would have been... Okay, so now I know that scene with the girl just now is also a factor into him helping me here. Oh my god. But now you guys are seeing firsthand how Kenny can get if you don't side with him with things.
What the fuck was that?
They're everywhere. You took care of yourself, didn't you?
Kenny? Now's not the time for this shit. Well then, that happened. Yeah, because I remember when I accidentally clicked the option to shoot the girl in a previous playthrough, and, you know, the door fell on top of me and the walkers were on me. He actually shoots, or he does something to help me, basically. So, interestingly, because I didn't do it, yeah. Also, it's cute to notice that she's wearing that hoodie that she didn't want to take.
You're back.
In the previous episode, so there's some continuity.
And I put him on my walkie.
Hey, sweet pea. That's neat. I'll find you in a minute.
Why are you so precious? So precious. Hi, bitch.
Looks like we got the kid on watch again.
What'd you get?
We might as well leave a sign out that says the men are gone and come and rape our women and children.
Damn, Kenny. Huh. I mean, kind of so, true, but damn.
Lot of stuff.
We're fine, by the way.
Nice work. This'll keep us going. If we carry on like this, we'll get through the winter here.
The winter? We'll freeze our asses off here.
Because piling into an RV with you after what you did to my dad is so appealing.
Why wouldn't it be? You know I'll do what it takes to keep everyone safe.
We're already safe.
You know what?
Take a look at the wall, Lily. That's not graffiti. Those are bullet holes. And we got enough arrow shafts sticking out of it to dry our laundry.
We have to go eventually, Lily.
I know, Lee. I know. Eventually is different. At it again, are we?
Can it, Carly?
Don't boss people around.
I'm sorry. Somebody needs to make executive decisions for the group, though. And I don't think you're capable any-
Everything can't come down to the same disagreement. Lily's concerns are valid, you know.
Of course you think they
are. God damn it, I'm not on anyone's side, Kenny. This is about everyone.
What about the food situation? What about protection? What about when this place falls? Somebody's got to be thinking about this shit.
How has this not been working? We have everything we need.
Because of me.
I don't like any of these choices.
Because Lee knows how to take care of people, not just things.
What about medicine?
We deal with shit as it comes, just like we always do.
And when 15 bandits hop over that wall in the middle of the night?
Yeah.
What then? You just gonna deal with that?
Yeah, he's
Everything
got a point there.
That happens to us is another excuse for you to pull this crap about leaving. All I want is a week of peace, of not hearing it.
Yeah, it
we
has been
be
a week.
We'd be fighting about
okay.
our medicine and supply stocks if Lee hadn't fucked up downtown.
What do you mean?
This... Some girl came screaming out of an alley. She had dead hanging all over her. She was making enough noise that we would have had plenty of time to get what we needed. Instead, smart guy shot her.
He what?
He put her out of her misery. Stupid.
I couldn't let her suffer.
We're all suffering.
Some more than
what
others.
What the actual fuck?
We've been
fuck
putting our lives on the line doing these runs into the city. You wouldn't believe the shit we see.
We all appreciate it, Ken.
Y'all should be giving Lee hell for not doing what needed to be done.
It's not so easy for him.
And now Bay's upset.
Look,
what the
Macon and its
fuck,
people aren't
Kenny?
Savable. It's not a town. It's full of walkers. And the people who were left are dying and wandering out onto the streets. It's hell on earth. And it's coming this way.
It's not going to be easier out on the road.
How would you know?
What I know? I know you're not above murder. I know somebody has been stealing our supplies. That's right, stealing. And I know the list of people I can trust here gets smaller every day. Now everybody get out.
Happy, Kenny?
My family's alive and that RV is running. You goddamn right I am.
Everyone is under great stress.
Well, all I know is, whenever this shit happens, I'm the fucking bad guy.
Well,
I'd like a thank you for once. For once!
You're not necessarily the bad guy, but you don't make things easier either, man. Like, seriously, did you have to bring up...
Oh, things are coming to a head.
You could say that.
This guy,
I
swear to God.
Well, I think you did good today. And I find myself thinking that most days.
Well, good, you're not mad at me.
It's probably worth following up with Lily about what she was saying about missing supplies. With her wound up the way she is, I don't want to see her paranoid.
No question.
And I'd like to talk when you've got a minute.
Love you, Bae. Alrighty. Well, that happened. So I guess I'll just go in here and talk to Nutsy McGee, just to see what the hell's going on. And then I'll go talk to Carly.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize.
Did you come in here to give me hell or to coddle me?
Why not both? No, seriously, though.
I wanted to follow up on what you said about stolen supplies.
Do you know what's going on?
I don't. I just heard you mention it.
Things are missing, and I could use your help. There's a traitor. Somebody, one of us, out there. He or she or they have been taking things.
Well, I'll try to pick the most...
For real? Who? What do you got?
Yes, for real. And I don't have shit. I just know.
Lily.
Counts off and it's the good stuff. Antibiotics, oxy, fuck, anything with opium in it.
I see the count, and it's fine.
I keep my own. That one's getting messed with. I'm a fucking mess right now, but I'm not stupid. I know what happens if I start a witch hunt.
So you want me to start one?
I want you to poke around.
What's there to go on?
I found this tossed into the garbage.
Huh.
We don't toss out equipment, we fix it. You'd only try to get rid of a flashlight if you were using it when you shouldn't.
Alright, whoa.
Seems like you're manufacturing this from nothing.
Prove me wrong. I'd really appreciate it.
I didn't actually mean to click that shit.
A mystery.
Oh, God.
Jesus, Doc.
And this music.
I'm sorry. I heard you guys talking.
You need to unhear all of that.
Can I help?
What did I just say?
You're the Grace Detective, and I can be Dick Grayson, your ward. That's Robin.
I know who it is.
That face.
You can help. Don't tell anybody.
Secrecy.
Yeah, good.
What do I do?
I don't know. Go look around. Let me know if you find anything weird.
I'm on the case.
God help us. Alright, so let me go find Carly. So it's interesting that it says Duck will help. So I guess there was a way. Like, I've never had Duck not help me, so I guess there might actually be...
Lily yet?
Yeah, I have.
She thinks supplies have been walking away.
Really?
There's some broken equipment, too. I'll look into it.
Thanks for doing that. What I wanted to say was, I've been thinking a lot about you.
I think about you, too.
Our group is small.
You're small.
You're a convicted killer.
Carly.
Jesus. Yeah, exactly.
People should know. Not because they deserve to, and not because you're a bad man. I think the opposite of those two things. People need to know because we're hanging by a thread here, and I can't see Lily talk about you without thinking it's the next thing she's going to say. You don't have to tell everyone. But think about who you trust and take the opportunity while you have it.
You're probably right.
Of course I'm probably right. People might be pissed, and telling them might cause some trouble, but it will be a far cry from what'll happen if they don't hear it from you.
Yeah.
So you'll do it then?
Yeah.
I'll let people know. You're totally right.
Good. I think it's for the best. Don't call me small.
She wants the D, y'all.
Is there anything else you want to talk about?
I guess I'll ask about the flashlight.
Do you know anything about this flashlight?
It's broken.
I know it's broken.
And the batteries might be in backwards.
It uses just one.
Everything should. What was the question?
Did you break the flashlight?
No.
Okay.
Okay. Actually, I've never clicked this before.
You, have any thoughts about Lily?
I worry about her. That's about it. She keeps trying to run things, but it's just not working.
Alright, well, I think I already know her opinions about how safe she feels here, and she just literally finished talking to me about if people are ready to hear about me, so we'll just go.
Look into this thing.
Good idea.
Alright, so this is what I was kind of talking about, I think at the end of the last episode. Interestingly, that whole little exchange, upstairs just now, like, well, obviously, if I had Doug in the party, that conversation wouldn't have happened. But it's also interesting to note that this is the only opportunity you get to reveal to people about your past. Like, if you have Doug, obviously he doesn't know about your past, and if you let Carly get killed in the pharmacy, there's no way to actually talk to the others about, you know, what happened before the apocalypse happened. So, kind of interesting. Kind of interesting. And I think this is touched on in a later episode, but I'm not going to really get into that right now. I will talk to them about the flashlight, and then...
Do you guys know anything about this broken flashlight?
Fuck. We don't got many of those.
Yeah, it's a problem. The glass and the bulb are all busted out.
I saw some broken glass over by the ice machine. I meant to clean it up before the kids hurt themselves on it. I forgot, though.
Okay, so now... Okay, great. I don't have to do the flashlight with each of them. So I guess... Believe it or not, I'm going to talk to Kenny first. Only because I feel like he's a little annoyed with me about what happened with the pharmacy, but I think apart from, like, Clementine and Carly, he's probably the other person I'm the closest with. So, yeah.
Hey, you two. How are you doing?
We're okay.
Just having a little spat.
We all carry guns now, and I don't like it.
I understand
it's
that.
It's the way it's gotta be.
There I you know, go.
But I'm not getting used to it.
That's fine, too.
I'm sorry. How are you, Lee?
I don't think that's something you really should get used to, if that makes sense. Because I'm pretty sure killing somebody or having to kill somebody, it changes people, you know? But Kenny.
Kenny, you got a second? I need to tell you something.
Yeah? What do you got?
I'm wondering if I should bother to tell Kadra, though. It definitely sits. Kenny, though.
Okay, should I sit down?
Come on.
Okay, so...
I was, on my way to prison 3 months ago.
No shit.
No shit.
Wasn't for touching kids, was it?
No, it wasn't.
Because we got two here.
I killed a guy in a fight.
Should I be worried there's anything else in your past that's gonna come out?
No.
Good. But you should know, if we gotta make numbers when it comes to a boat, this is gonna matter.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? Yeah, I can't really fault him for feeling that way. Like, I know for a fact that if I was in Kenny's shoes, I would have said the same thing. But at the same time, I know how Kenny feels about... Like, it's interesting that he was like, did you go to jail for touching kids? So, it's nice to see that he's always looking out for the children, you know? So, that's kind of cool. But I am going to actually talk to Kadra about this, too. Might as well.
Can I talk to you about something?
Sure. Is everything okay?
Well, don't... I feel like she needs to know, Kenny.
I was, on my way to prison 3 months ago.
Let's not
You've always looked at me with kind eyes. I wonder if you could still do that if you, knew I was a convicted felon.
My goodness, for what? How much trouble can a teacher get into?
Well, plenty. But it had nothing to do with that. It was for murder.
Why?
He and my wife,
That's enough. Tell me what happened when you were locked in the fridge at the dairy.
Oh. Okay. That's why Kenny made that face just now. Alright. Before, like, I knew that you had the opportunity to talk to the people here at the camp and tell them that you were a killer. And I think when I previously had this option, like, I forgot to actually talk to Kenny and Katja. So, this is interesting, though. Also, I feel like not telling her is just gonna make things worse, but at the same time, it's interesting that Kenny didn't really talk about what happened, so, However, I did just kind of tell her something really revealing about me, and I feel like I owe it to her to continue to be honest, if that makes sense. Okay.
I was giving Larry CPR with Lily.
No, you weren't.
Kenny came in from out of nowhere and put a stop to it.
No, you weren't. What the fuck are you talking about?
He smashed his head in.
You weren't giving him CPR? Well, great way to make Kenny look like a monster in this scenario. You were just as...
Gotcha.
Everything keeps changing.
I should have kept my mouth shut. I'm so angry right now. What the actual fuck? What the fuck? Like, I'm wondering if somehow... Like, I used to see this happen with other players when they played this game. Like, especially, like, if... Oh, you know what? I'm thinking of Season 2. Like, this used to happen a lot with Season 2, like, when you would play a new episode. And, I don't know, like, something would happen with the people's saves files, and there would be an option when you would start Season 2 to import your choices from Season 1 into, you know, the save file. And sometimes the choices would get messed up. And then sometimes, if you didn't have the save file, you could just tell the game to just pick choices at random. And sometimes it would actually pick decisions that you didn't make when you played the game for the first time. This, however, is pretty weird. Like, I know for a fact that I didn't give Larry CPR. Like, I chose to help Kenny. So if anything, Lee should have... That is really weird. Bro, what the actual fuck was that about?
A flashlight was broken. Was it you?
No.
You're not in trouble if it was. I know you get nervous and maybe you went out to go to the bathroom, broke it, got worried and tossed it.
What's with the third degree? I didn't break any flashlight.
Okay then.
Alright. I might as well just tell everybody what's up, going on.
Hey, Ben, I need to tell you something.
Surely, is it about my watch? I'm trying to do a good job.
You're doing fine. I was on my way to prison before this.
Whoa, seriously? What were you in for?
It's not important.
Oh.
Just, if you hear anything, it's probably true. And now you know.
Thanks for trusting me, man.
Ben, relax.
Okay.
Okay, again, what the fuck, Lee? You told Kenny and Katja that you were going to prison for murder. You couldn't tell Ben? Like, I get he's a teenager, but I feel like he could handle that. I don't know what's going on here. I really don't. Where is... Oh, here she is.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
You didn't accidentally break a flashlight, did you?
No. Did Duck say I did?
No. Did Duck break the flashlight?
I don't think so. He's just always blaming me for stuff.
Like what?
Putting a bug on his pillow.
Did you do that?
Yes.
I love this kid. Ooh, that clipping texture.
Hey, Clementine.
Haley.
I feel like with Clementine, I need to kind of inch my way into telling her, so I'm going to ask her this first, and then I'll talk
to her. What's that you're working on, Clem?
It's called a leaf rubbing. My teacher, Miss Moore, showed us how to do them when we went to the botanical garden once. See? It's the same. Kind of.
Oh, that's really something.
You tried,
Clem. I'll make one for you, too.
Okay. Actually, I don't think they mention how old he is. I think he's high school, though. Because, in the second episode when we meet him, he's with another classmate and his teacher. And, I mean, technically they could have been college age, but he really looks like he's high school. He's just super tall. Like, it's funny, some people call him the Shaggy of The Walking Dead because he does look like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo. But I do think that he's high school. Yeah, I do think he's like about 17 or 16. He's just really, really tall. Then again, everybody's really, really tall compared to me. I'm like 5'3", so. But he's like, I think, even taller than Lee. And Lee looks like he's about the average height for a male. But I gotta talk some seriousness with my poor little Clemmy, so.
Clem, I need to talk to you for a second.
Okie dokie.
I think I actually...
The day you and I met, I was in a car accident.
I remember. Your leg was bleeding.
Yeah.
The car I was in was a police car, and I was on my way to jail for committing a crime. I need to tell you now, because I don't want you to hear it any other way.
Okay.
Do you have anything to say?
I don't think so.
You can go on back to your things.
Oh. Does she, though? Because she looks... Well, you know what? Let me not even say that, because a thing that us grown-ups tend to do a lot of, which I'm ashamed to admit, is that we often try to downplay how much a kid understands the situation. Like, she's 8 years old, if I'm not mistaken, but she seems pretty on the ball with certain things, you know? Like, when you try to explain things to her, or when you do certain things, like, she pretty much understands what's going on. I mean, a lot of the time, I kind of don't want to talk to her about certain things or do certain things. Like, in the previous plays of episode 2, I opted to not kill the brothers, because I knew she was... Like, I knew, like, the way this game was structured, it was going to happen if I killed one of the brothers in front of her. She would then miraculously appear behind me and be like, no, Lee, you know? So, there's that. But at the same time, you know, like, when I explained to her why I killed them last episode, she was upset, understandably. But I do feel like she understood that it was a hard decision I had to make, but I made it, you know, for her safety, with her safety in mind.
Hey.
Find anything?
Not yet. I'm still looking.
I haven't found out anything.
Well, there's
yet.
Nothing to find in here. Ask around. Jesus, investigate.
Okay.
Calm your tits. I came in here to tell you something. I just wanted to at least tell you I didn't find anything. Fuck. It makes me almost don't want to tell her, but again, she's so fucking paranoid right now. Like, I feel like I don't know. Like, I feel like if I don't tell her and she somehow finds out later, that's going to be an issue. But at the same time, maybe that'll kind of work to my advantage by telling her, if that makes sense. You know? Because if you think about it, I by all means, don't have to tell her what happened to me before the apocalypse, but by being upfront about it and telling her, I don't know, maybe she'll have some sort of respect for me about being honest.
I need to tell you something.
Sure, go ahead. But if it's bad news, maybe save it.
I was sent to prison before the plague.
Interesting that he calls it the plague.
What?
Dad said there was something about you.
Oh.
So you know.
I didn't know what to know.
Well, it's true, and I'm sorry.
He treated you like shit, knew who you were, and you tried to save his life. The last thing you need to do is apologize.
Thank you. That's all I wanted to hear. Thank you.
You killed a guy. So what? I bet he was a dick.
Well, it ruined my life.
Good thing everyone else has got destroyed shortly thereafter, huh? Misery loves company.
Well, I'll be damned. She smiled. She smiled. She thanked me. She... Okay. Okay, Lily. You kind of gained some points with me just now. Alright. Okay. That, I... Okay. Wasn't expecting that. Alright. Also, this must
be
where...
There's some broken glass on the ground there.
Okay. Clementine has been here, I can tell. Looks cute, though. I can walk over here, though. Can I... Wait, did I look at it or did I inspect it? Hold on. Sorry. Okay, there we go. Ah, okay, now I can... Okay. Can I say, it feels like I'm supposed to do something here. Gotta remember to actually inspect stuff, not just look at it.
Chalk.
Pink.
Duck.
A clue.
Maybe.
What do you think it is?
I don't think it's anything.
Maybe it's a sign.
It could be. It's pink chalk, which is weird.
Okay, back to investigating.
This detective music whenever he shows up, I swear. Also, I seriously doubt Clem has a part to play in this. Like, it just doesn't make sense. Like, I'm not saying that, somebody could have, like, coerced her into, giving up the chalk, but it seems very unlikely that, she would have been involved in this. If anything, somebody took the chalk from her and made the mark on the wall. Also, though, the bandits would have had to been, like, extreme ninjas, or, you know, basically this means that somebody in here is, in fact, working with them.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
Do, you have any pink chalk?
No, it's gone somewhere. Do you want blue?
No, it's okay.
Psst, Lee. I found something.
What is it?
I found this piece of pink chalk and a scuff of it over by the gate.
Really?
Totally. I was combing the scene for clues and...
Yeah, Duck, I got it. Good job.
Yeah, okay, fine.
Cool!
This kid. Oh, God.
You didn't break the flashlight, did you, Duck?
No, Mom and Dad won't let me touch any of their stuff. Lily neither.
That's probably for the best.
Okay, is there anything else that I can talk to him about? Oh, okay, interesting that I can't... Actually...
Have you found anything else?
Just the chalk. I also found some bugs underneath the stairs. Don't tell Clementine.
Right.
Okay, I won't.
Okay, so yeah, this is the only other choice that I can make here. It's interesting that I don't have a choice to talk to Duck about why or rather the fact that I was going to prison before all this. Then again, like, I don't know, like, a lot of people, interestingly, like, I've seen other playthroughs of this, and a lot of people seem to hate Duck, like, with a passion of a thousand burning suns. Like, they just hate this kid. And, I mean, he is a little annoying at times, but I don't know. Like, I feel like, too, maybe it's just me, I'm probably totally wrong about this, but he seems like a little, like, I don't know if the right word is slow, but something is, like, off about this kid, you know what I mean? But he's a nice kid, though.
You seem to know a bit about all of this. The chalk, you found the scuff here. This is gonna sound crazy, but you're not involved, are you?
No, I'm a good guy.
Stay inside the gate.
I will.
Also, I have no idea if he's actually older than Clem, or younger, or if they're the same age. Like, that's never really, established, I think. Like, I do know that they mentioned Clem's age in the,
He was over here, too.
In the game. Like,
see,
the only-
I did good, huh?
Yes, you did.
Duck, you did. I suppose I should go out there and look around. You stay here this time. Seriously.
Okay.
Like, Lee and Clementine are the only two people I know that their ages are confirmed in the game, you know? Like, Lee said he was 37, which makes him actually older than me by a few years. And, I think in the first episode, maybe? Yeah, it was the first episode, because I think there was a scene where you talk with Katja and Clementine, and she talks about how old she is. And the fact that she's in the first grade. Which is weird, because here in the States, if you're 8 years old, that usually means that you're about in third or fourth grade. So I don't know what's up with that.
It's a bag or something.
I meant this. No. Yes. That. Pick it up. Not look at it. I can see it's a bag.
Son of a bitch.
Here we go. Shit's about to get real.
You haven't come up with anything, have you?
I came up with this.
Yeah.
It's got a bunch of meds in it. It was in a grate on the outside wall. And there's a sign on the other one.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Okay, we line everybody up. Everybody. Somebody is killing us. Stealing from that supply is the same as slipping into your room at night and cutting your throat while you sleep. You die.
Jesus, Lily.
What is the difference? What if Clementine gets sick and we don't have what we need?
Yeah, but I wouldn't go as far as to say it's like slitting your throat.
Steal from us!
Who the fuck is that?
Y'all
got our people out there.
We ain't fucking around.
What do we do?
Oh,
Lily.
Shit. They're gonna start kicking indoors any second.
Lily, what the hell are you-
Stall him.
What?
Just keep him talking. Do whatever it takes to stop him pulling the trigger.
You made the biggest mistake of your life.
Shit.
Indeed.
Enough of this bullshit. Drew, stop putting your boot to these doors.
Yeah.
Hold it, asshole.
Take it easy.
Okay.
We have more supplies. We can keep the deal going.
Too late, shithead. We ain't giving second chances.
It was a mix-up. We'll make it worth your while.
I'm listening.
We can split the supplies. Spread them around.
Or we could just kill you and take it all.
And what about when they run out? When you don't have us out there collecting them for you?
Well, I suppose we ought to hash out some terms, then.
I don't like no hash.
Man, shut up, bro!
Crash! Oh, shit!
Savage. Good work, Carly. Also, fuck you. You only shot him in the ass! This guy...
Get back there!
Also, I still don't understand to this day, how did they show up so quickly?
We gotta get out of here!
Like,
shit.
After I took the bag of medicine, you know what I mean? Like,
RV.
I don't get that. They're like fucking ninjas. Like, how did they... Okay, let me stop talking and pay attention to what I'm doing here. Wait, where are they? Ooh. Okay.
Go around, shit, the brain. He's not there.
Okay, got him. Damn. Okay, where are you? Come on. Got him.
Now! Get over here! Hurry!
Man, you saved our asses.
Get in the truck. Or whatever. Fuck. Just go. Sweet baby.
Help!
Hatcha, hang on!
Okay, the other side. Oh,
where
great.
Is he?
Alright.
Right behind that van. Get your asses around behind.
Come on. Ooh, missed. That almost could have been me. Oh, God, I'm fucking up. What am I doing? Get away from them. Oh, damn. So he can get really close. Okay, good to know. Do over.
Help!
Gotcha! Hang on!
Zombie eats you.
Where is
so is you right? Okay.
He's right behind that van. Get your asses around behind.
Okay, where are you? Got him. Okay, now for this asshole. What are you doing? There we go. Okay, well, there's another one somewhere. Where is he? Where the fuck is he? Okay, there he is.
Cut! Hurry! Come on!
Please!
Cliff, get inside the RV! It's gonna be okay! Go!
Oh, why not? Wow.
Oh, Christ!
How hard did she hit her head?
Screw her! Let her stay!
Kenny. Okay, this is interesting. Am I playing as Carly right now? Oh no, I'm playing as Lee still. But she helps with shooting these guys, so that's good to know. Okay, go over here now. I think if I had Doug... I can't remember what he does. I think he basically calls out which side to look out for them. Okay, good work, Carly.
Last chance, get down here!
Come on, woman.
Shit.
No holding this place anymore.
Cat, Jesus, are you okay?
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. I'm sorry.
Everything's fine,
Ben. Everything's not fine. We need to figure out how this happened.
We just lost everything.
Well, we're lucky as shit to have this RV.
And nobody died.
Cat's head is split open.
I'm fine.
Somebody in here caused this.
Settle down back there. The bandits have had our number for weeks.
Lily's right, though.
Somebody was working with them. Whoever it was slipping them our meds. They didn't get their last package, so they attacked.
Calm down back there. That's nuts.
Lee found a bag of supplies hidden outside the wall.
It's true.
So, Carly, is there something you want to say?
Really?
Please. We have to get it out of you, then.
Back off.
You're in no position to make demands.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You're just pointing fingers.
I didn't just come up with...
Why do I keep clicking out of the window?
I've had my suspicions.
Holly's trustworthy. She's not a traitor, Lily.
Thank you, Lee. She can fight her own battles. Unless there's something going on here that implicates you both.
Lily.
Don't be ridiculous.
Like, seriously.
Look, maybe we should vote or something like that.
Vote? What?
Just look! Carly's a stand-up gal!
I don't want to say just let it go because this is pretty serious, but this is not a good time, so you know what?
We'll deal with it.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's just let it go. People make mistakes, and yeah, this is a fucking doozy.
Yeah.
It's not worth it, Lily.
Then what do we not forgive?
Honestly, tell me. Kenny can kill my dad. Carly can steal from us. Where's the line?
Why do you think so much that it's her?
Was
if anything, blame the new guy.
What?
I've seen you two together. Was it both of you?
Look, just let me out. I didn't do it, but I don't like this. I don't like where it's headed.
Look me in the eyes and tell me you didn't have anything to do with it. Lily, lay off of him.
I...
Shit! What's going on up there?
I hit something. We gotta stop.
Thank God that wasn't actually a human.
We can deal with this
though
now.
I think a human would have jumped out of the way in time. But still, oof.
Kenny, is it safe?
Should be.
Everybody out.
Lily?
Out.
You thinking I should leave Lily? Has anyone actually seen what happens when you take her?
Kenny, the RV
out of curiosity.
Damage, but there's a walker trapped underneath.
God damn it. Everyone keep your eyes peeled.
You know what? We shouldn't just kick you out. We should hear what everybody thinks.
I think you should chill out.
I'm not gonna take this. You can push Ben around, but you can't push me around.
This is not the place to be doing this. I mean, it does have to be discussed, but this is not the place for it.
I'm not doing this.
Come on, Lee. You're the one who found them. You can't
I know
just
that.
Abstain.
Fuck all that. This is nuts. We're out
Thank
here on the
you.
Side of the road.
Thank you.
Okay, fine then. Kenny?
How's he gonna input? He's trying to get rid of the walker.
Stop, would you?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, your vote counts for you and Katja.
We don't need all these votes. What do I have to do for you to trust me? I'll do anything. I'll do watches for months.
Huh, the hell you will.
I'll get more food, more medicine, anything.
Stop panicking. Seriously, Ben. You need to stop and just take a breath.
Do we need any more evidence than this? Fuck evidence. Stop treating him like this. Shut up, Carly. Ugh, I've heard enough out of you. Kenny, what's it gonna be?
Just give me a damn minute.
Ben, you have until that walker is dealt with to tell me it was her and not you. Stop this. You're torturing him.
No.
Ben, stop. This is about trust, and I've never trusted you.
I did it.
What?
Yeah, it was me. That get you to lay off the kid?
I think you're capable of being a real piece of shit. But I know it wasn't you. Not with her in your life.
There! I got him.
Please, let's just get back
That's
in the
That's not
RV.
Happening.
That's interesting
you're
that she...
You're a bitch, don't you? Like nothing can hurt you. But you're just a scared little girl. Get the fuck over it. Take a page from Lee's book and try helping somebody for once.
This is why Carly is bae. Also...
Now, what the fuck's the problem?
Yeah.
Drop it!
That growl just now, holy shit.
Holy fuck.
Kenny! What's happening?
You duck away from the windows! Jesus Christ! Get in! We're leaving this crazy bitch!
She couldn't be trusted, Lee. I swear.
Oh, boy.
What are we gonna do with her?
You're not coming with us.
I'll die out here.
I don't care.
You're a murderer, Lily. We can't have you with us.
Murderer? Lee's killed before and I forgave him. You've killed before and I'll forgive you.
Bullshit,
you
will.
Know we
You've
do
been planning to get
to
me
done.
This entire time.
I was trying to protect all of us. I don't have anything left.
Get in, Lee. Let's go, you guys.
Kind of ironic that she was saying she forgave Kenny for what he did to her. Well, not even just he. I helped too, but he was the one with the salt lick in his hand. However, like, she did kind of respect me, I think, to some extent for telling the truth about my past. But I still feel like she was harboring a grudge for Kenny. And... yeah. I think I'll talk more about this towards the end, because there's going to be some heavy stuff coming in a bit. But, yeah.
Lee, a word, please?
Okay. I'll get there in a second, Contra. I do want to comment, though, on how... that scene would have played out if you had Doug in your party. So, interestingly, when...
We need to speak to you up here.
Gotcha. Give me a second, hun. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna pause the game because she's gonna keep interrupting while I commentate. What, that scene plays out differently, and it actually kind of makes things interesting, in my opinion. If, Doug was in the party, you know, unfortunately... Fortunately, I gotta spoil and say that he doesn't make it either. Like, this is one of the things that kind of irked me about season one, and that the choice to save either Carly or Doug didn't really matter in the end, because they both bite the bullet, no pun intended, in this episode. However, in Doug's case, his death is actually accidental. Like, instead of, like, you know how, like, Lily blamed Carly right off the bat during that scene? She was like, Carly, you know, you're the one giving away the meds. She actually blames Ben. And, you know, when they get outside the van and they're arguing and blah, 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 she actually, you know, points the gun at Ben. And Doug sees this. And he actually jumps in between Lily and Ben. And that's how he gets shot. And interestingly, when he, you know, falls to the ground, Lily looks mortified at what she did. Like, you can tell by the look on her face that she definitely didn't mean to shoot Doug. You know, like, it was accidental. In this case, it was flat out, you know, premeditated that she wanted Carly dead. And I think a part of that plays into the fact that Carly, you know, spoke up and yelled at her. You know, plus, of course, she didn't, what do you call it? She, I guess, suspected Carly anyway of being responsible for the bandit attack. But, I don't know, I just found that interesting that depending on who you pick, their manner of death, like in Doug's case, it was accidental. In Carly's case, it was, you know, she meant to do it. And I think in a weird way, that kind of determined whether or not I took Lily with us or not. So, like, in the playthrough where I had Doug in the party, I actually opted to take Lily with us. And in the playthrough, and then obviously in this playthrough, when I had Carly in the party, I opted to not take her. Because, well, I'll get into it more later, but I just wanted to mention that a bit. Because I know some people haven't seen what happens if Doug is in the group. I'm coming. I had to talk to the people. You gotta understand, I gotta commentate.
What's up? Is Doug feeling all right? What the fuck
happened during the raid?
Yeah.
What's the plan? We've never had a bite victim in the group before.
I'm going to keep an eye on him and see what I can do from a medical perspective.
We keep the same plan unless something changes. East.
Guys.
What else is there to do?
We thought you should know.
Important to stay honest with each other.
Nice. Okay.
Anyway, if you could tell Clementine, we would appreciate it.
So me being honest with him, like, he would have been a lot... Well, he would have just basically said something to the effect that at least we were honest with you, you know? So the fact that I was honest with them first, that kind of helped with that scene just now. Yeah, let me go talk to Clem. Because I don't think you could really say much to Ben back there.
Duck is bitten.
Huh?
He got bit by a walker trying to escape the motel.
I don't feel good.
I know, hon.
What about Carly?
Gone, but won't come back.
Because she was shot in the head.
That's right. It's horrible.
Yeah, it is.
I'm really sorry you had to see that, too. Like, this is another reason why I was so annoyed with Lily. Like, I'm not saying that she was a bad shot, but God forbid... Like, somebody had tried to intervene, and they knocked the gun, and she shot somebody else, too.
I'm glad I have you.
Me, too. I heard you outside my treehouse that day, and thought about dropping a hammer on your head.
That's nice.
I didn't, though.
Yeah, you didn't.
Thanks.
Man. At the end, I think I'll talk about how differently this episode would have played out if you did take Lily. But
what happened?
Right now, I gotta concentrate on this mindfuckery right here. God.
We got something up
ahead. Rip my keyboard. You know, I just realized this is a super long episode in comparison to the other ones. Like, I feel like when we did episode 1 and 2, like, the episode would have been ending already right about now, it feels. Like, there's a lot of shit that happens in this one. In season 3? I don't know. Because she was, yeah, like, she looked like she was about a teenager in the,
Is there any way to get around it?
Previews.
Doesn't look like it. On foot, maybe. Can't really afford
it. So depending on how much time elapsed between season 2 and season 3, that will tell you, a lot.
Anything from creeping up on us.
She was about a preteen in season 2, so the fact that she looked like a teenager in season 3, I'm guessing probably 2 years, maybe 3 tops.
Yeah, everyone else relax. Clint, stay close to Kenny and Kat, okay?
Lee, if you come across anything to drink, if there's a dining car or something, I think Duck's a bit dehydrated.
It's a freighter, huh?
Yeah, that doesn't necessarily mean that there's not water.
What? You think there might be something dangerous inside an abandoned locomotive? That would cross my mind.
Alright. And I gotta actually... Can I exit out? Okay, never mind. Okay, time to explore. Excuse me, 1 second. Got the hiccups. And I have something here to drink and they're still not abating. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too, how old the kid was that was with her by the end of season 2.
Living in here.
Yeah, that would be a good way to tell about how much older she is.
I hope so, but this looks recently used. Be on the lookout and have your guard up.
Alright, well here's water for, what's his face?
I'll take this to Kanja, for Doug.
Yeah. What else is here to look around at? There's a map, so we'll take that.
A map of where the train goes. I think these tracks might lead to the coast. Route 27, Savannah. That's where Kenny's got us headed.
Okay, is there anything else in here? Like, sometimes it's hard to tell what you're supposed to, like, try and interact with versus what you... What's just basically, decorative, or... Okay, so I think I'm on the other side of the, or maybe this is the way I came in, I can't tell. Oh, okay, so... Look at the couple bar, look at the couple pin. Okay, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to get that,
there's gotta be a better way to do this.
Open, or up, or whatever.
Shit. Broken.
Okay. Yeah, I think I gotta find something to actually lift that up. Because I'm pretty sure if we try to... Like, when... I know we're gonna have to get the train running, but I think that if we don't do that in the back... This train's not gonna budge because it's being, like, anchored in place, for lack of a better word, because of that thing in the back. What ending did you choose for season 2? Actually, when I played it, you know, again, I usually play it more than once so I can see how different the endings play out. First of all, I was so salty by the end of season 2, you have no idea. But, I'm not gonna say what I actually did, only because it's gonna spoil. I know Tim is actually playing this himself, And I don't want to spoil what happens in season 2, so I can't really say what ending I chose. Let's just say that I chose both endings, for lack of a better word. And, I haven't actually decided which path I'm going to take when I replay season 2 yet.
Shit.
It does feel like I'm being a little more pragmatic this time around, so I might choose the choice that seems shitty, for lack of a better word, but it's for the better good. Then again, I don't know. We'll see. Because I hate a particular character in season 2, I still might... I don't know. We'll see. Ooh. You don't know. When I played season 2 for the first time and I got that ending decision, though, I was so fucking mad. Like, I literally had to pause the game and walk away for about an hour before I came back and actually finished the episode, even though there were only, like, maybe 5 minutes left to the episode. Like, that's how upset I was with that last big decision I had to make.
I don't think this guy came back.
Christ. That light is blinking.
Push it.
Push it?
Why not?
Are you fucking serious?
Here, look.
Yeah, I gotta be vague because, like I said, there's one guy that watches my streams named Tim.
Fucker works.
He commented a couple times in the comment section today, but
how the hell do we get it moving?
He hasn't played the game or seen any gameplay for season 2 yet, surprisingly. So good on him for not getting spoiled. I'm definitely not going to be the one to spoil it for him, so.
I think so.
This horse will take us right to Savannah. 100 tons of steel. Put 1,000 walkers between us and the ocean, and we don't have to give a shit.
Not to mention, like I said, I'm still not even entirely sure what I'm going to do, so.
Just have to figure out how to get it started.
Not sure even paid attention to the conversation you're having here.
But we'll find out.
I don't think it pays to talk about Duck right now.
If you could keep an eye on the girls and Duck, I'd appreciate it. I'm gonna make sense of these controls. Man, this could be exactly what we need.
Well, why are you looking sad, Ben? I mean, that's an important job. What about this? Can we do anything with that, or?
Bunch of maps about Georgia's cities. About the train.
Oh, that was the guy that drove the train here. That's always like sad to think about when you play like certain games like this and you see like the remnants of people that once were living happy lives, or at least normal lives. I shouldn't say happy because not everybody is fortunate enough to what is this?
Shit, this is it.
Oh,
instructions on
starting
the engine.
This thing.
Damn, pages ago. See the indentations from the writing.
Oh, I remember what we gotta do here. I remember. Clem, I need your help, hon. Oh, wait, actually? Wait a minute, hold on. I don't remember if I have to take this with me or if I... No, I can't even. Okay, so I do have to talk to Clem. Because remember a short while ago she was talking about, what do you call it? Leaf rubbings? So I bet I have to get like a crayon or something. And I could maybe like rub the paper and we'll see what was underneath it, you know? Because that was one thing that I had a bad habit of doing when I was still in school. Like I used to press down really hard on the paper when I wrote. So then when I would turn the page in like my loose leaf notebook or whatever, the indentations of what I wrote on the previous page would be pressed into the paper below it, so it's a little annoying. So this is basically the same concept, I'm thinking.
There's a notepad on the train. Do you have any pencils or anything in your pack?
No, I wish. Maybe in the RV. What do you need it for?
There used to be something written on the notepad that I need to know about.
Well, if you're not using it, I'd take it. I'm out of paper, and there's all sorts of new leaves around here.
Okay. So, I was originally, like I said, I was originally going to talk about, like, the Lily decision when I got to the end, but I'm going to talk about it now since I'm going into the RV. So, the interesting thing about if you actually choose to take Lily with you. I know, I think it was Spa that said it a second ago. Well, not a second, a few minutes ago. That they made the decision. And I'm sorry if you're a boy or a girl, I can't really tell from the username. But they made the decision to take Lily. So what would have happened here is like that scene where, you know, we learn about Duck getting bitten and whatnot. She would have been sitting in the back with Ben. And Ben would have had the gun like pointed at her, like he was on guard watching her. And then, you know, obviously we all get out of the RV here to go and investigate the train. So then when I came back in here to get the pencil, she would have been standing up in the back with her handcuffs off. Like, I don't know how the fuck she did that. And, of course, Lee would have been surprised at the fact that she was free from her bindings. And this is the interesting thing. What she says and does, I think, is determined based on whether or not you, you know, killed, well, not killed, but, you know, helped to kill Larry in the meat locker. And if you had more or less sided with her during a lot of the arguments between her and Kenny. And, like, I remember one time, or actually the one time I took her with me, she more or less said to Lee, come with me. And I was like, what the fuck are you talking about, lady? Like, come with you where? Like, where are you going to go? And she was like, you know, like, we can survive. Like, it was weird. Like, I won't say it was like anything like romantic tied to it. It was just really weird that she was like, you know, like, you can come with me. We can leave everybody behind and you can come with me. And she's like, you know, Clementine can come with us. Like, it was really weird, guys. But I think a lot of it played into the fact that because I had sided with her with a lot of my decisions, like, she was willing to, like, take me with her, for lack of a better word. But I don't know, because I think out of curiosity, like, I was curious to see where this conversation was going to go. I said, let me go get Clementine. But I think I kind of said that to allow my, you know, allow her to let me leave the RV. Because then I was going to try to run over to Kenny and tell him, hey, this chick got loose. What are we going to do about that, you know? But then as soon as I got out of the RV, she took off in the RV and left us. So I don't know. Like, I don't know if she just said that to be saying that or if she actually did, like, respectfully and likely enough that she actually would have been willing to take us with her. So that basically was pretty interesting, but yeah, because we left her on the side of the road, none of that happened. So now let me go. Oh, you know what? I just realized something. Hold on. On my way back, I need to check something. I think I walked right past it when I was talking. Yep, here it is.
Might be something inside.
I know that, Lee. Open it. Oh, okay. This is the wrong one. There's like three of these doors that I'm supposed to fiddle around with. So I think it's...
Might be something inside.
Lee, open it. I don't want you to just stare at it. Okay, yeah, this is it. So, I gotta grab one of these doohickeys. And, I think... I don't think it actually matters which one you take. Like, if that makes sense. But because that thing in the back has, like, a... I think I should take, like, one of the more pointed ones. Again, I really don't think it matters in the end, but... How do I... Oh. I just hit the back button. It's kind of hard for me to see right now because I have, like, notifications popped up on my, desktop. You can't see them, though, because it's only, capturing what's in the window, but it's kind of annoying me because I can't mouse... Actually, maybe I can pause real quick. Hold on. Ah, there we go. Get rid of these notifications. There we go. All right. Because it was preventing me from seeing the bottom right of my screen, so now I can actually see what I'm doing. Okay, so, yeah, take this and use the pencil.
Perfect. You can read it now? Yeah. Should be able to just follow the steps to get the engine on.
Sounds good.
Okay, so section number 6, down, down, up, up. Fuck, I'm not gonna remember this. I'm getting old, I'm getting senile at my old age. Down, down, up, 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 down, up. Somebody try to remember that for me, please. Because we'll be here forever. I know I'm gonna have to refer back to this anyway, like when I get to section 5 and 9, but maybe I should just do section 5 first. Okay, go over here. No, over here. Use console. There we go. Alright, so actually, I probably should do this. Down, down. I think this was up. Oh, it's giving me the option to look at it. Cool. Okay, good. I was a little worried about that for a second. So, up, up, up in the middle. And then I think the last one was up. Yep. Okay.
Son
great.
Of a bitch. Whatever you did lit the dash up.
So far, so good.
Okay, so now number 5 only had like 2 options. Left, or I should say sideways, and then vertical. So sideways. Yep.
Now we're talking.
So now, I think, what was the last one? Number 9? So we got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, right, there is a thing outside. That's probably number 9. Okay, so let me see if that is actually correct, if this is number 9. Yep, this is number 9. Okay, so this thing is telling me I need to turn to the left like Beyonce, and then I need to turn to the right. Okay, so to the left, and then to the right. Nice.
Holy shit! We're golden!
Yeah, we are. Golden. Man, feels good.
Like, a part of me wants to talk about this. Duck, but
Mom,
I don't know.
Let's see if she'll move.
Also, I'm curious to see how this conversation with Kenny is going to go down, because eventually we are going to have to kind of, like, confront him about what to do about Duck, and
all yours.
It could go either way. Like, I don't know. Like, for some people, it's really hard to... Oh, right, this stupid thing.
Damn it.
I forgot.
Of course. We're still attached.
Actually...
You go find out where we're stuck, get us unstuck.
Yeah.
Actually, now that I think about it, I think I had to do that first, anyway. Because you notice how all that dust plumed up when, the train moved? I think that was rust. So, even if I hadn't come back to Kenny to turn that on, I don't think I would have been able to pull that coupler pin anyway, because, how the fuck do I get out of here? Ugh. Can I? Yeah. 3 months spoiled food. Lovely. I guess I could go out. Yeah, I know you can go out here later on in the episode, but maybe I could come down here and go around the- Oh, shit! Fucking hell. I'm alright. I'm okay. Yeah, I'm alright. Animal crackers? I mean, the kids could probably use that. I probably have to kill you first. Yeah, that's what it looks like. Okay, I think I can do this without getting killed. So let me open the door.
This door's gonna hurt.
Okay. So, I think Lee just gave me an idea. I should unlock this, obviously. And I guess I'll have to slam his head in the door. That sounds lovely.
Okay. You aren't gonna like this.
Get ready. Okay, well, I got snacks. That's all that matters. Got snacks. Shit. You know, it's kind of ironic, because I can't even go around that way. So I can't... Actually, oh, I can go around the front. Oh, okay. I was going to say, I was going to get mad that I came down that ladder only to get freaking jump-scared by the zombie, but I can get around this way, so that's good. That's good. Alright, so let me... Actually, since I'm here, let me talk to Katja, give her the water, and I guess the snacks? Although, whatever. I don't care. She can share them with Clem and the others. Yeah, I can't even, like, Alright, yeah, I'll give her both of them.
Here, found some water.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you knew that jump scare was coming, Spa?
I'm allergic to bees.
Is that right?
It's all I can keep thinking about. Like, somehow that matters.
It doesn't.
I know. Well, I don't. But you're probably right.
Okay, so I gave you the water. And I'll give you the crackers.
Hey, I found these.
It I haven't had animal crackers in freaking... I don't know how long.
Fussy, you know?
What?
Most kids, they're really fussy about what they'll eat. Hate vegetables, that kind of thing.
Not Duck, huh?
No. The most trouble I ever have is making him use a fork.
Thank That's you. Good.
Sure.
I mean, I'm a grown-ass woman and I hate certain vegetables. And he'll eat anything you put on his plate. Literally, as we saw in episode 2, but... Yeah. Alright, so... Where is this thing? Oh, that's right. I have to go, I think, this way. And then I can get to the thing that I need to open up. Okay. So, yeah. Alright, I thought that I could kind of go around that other way and do it. Alright, not a big deal. So I gotta go this way now. And now I should be able to do this. Yeah.
There. Hey, Kenny, we're loose.
Yeah. If I'm not mistaken, I think that if I had came back here first before asking Kenny to start the train, I wouldn't have been able to even lift that up because of the rust that had set in. So, okay. I'm kind of doing things in order. And an autosave, so something's about to happen.
You touching my stuff?
Oh, hey, buddy. Ease up. Don't be walking up. I'll be honest.
I took the map of the train routes.
That's fine. You can have that.
Really? Yeah. I got them all right up here.
I bet you do.
I guess it's no worse for wear. Name's Chuck. Charles, if you fancy.
Lee.
That your crew outside?
Yeah.
And the guy up in the cab?
Him too.
I saw you walking through here and thought about scaring the pants off you.
What?
But I couldn't force myself to do it.
Kinda glad you didn't.
Still kinda freaking me out.
Lee.
Plain folk will do that. Already met everyone outside. They all warmed to me right quick in direct sunlight.
Can you blame them? I mean, you basically like Assassin Creed-ed your way into the group.
I did.
Seriously, so there was like no time to for a change. For you to show up.
He gave us candy. Ben too.
Ben.
You have candy.
Boy, I got the last piece I got on me.
Figures. You met Kenny?
Sure did. Man shares my love of the road.
That's for certain.
Ooh. That animation
sorry,
joke.
Your son's not feeling good.
I appreciate your concern.
Well,
With a little TLC, I'm sure he'll be fit as a fiddle in no time. And I can offer y'all whatever I got, although it ain't much.
Thank you. We'd like to do the same.
Why don't we hold off on...
Stay with us. We'd like the company.
I'm sensing a little something between them two. Okay. Well, now I can go and actually start up. Oh.
So that's it? We're cut loose?
Yeah.
Seems that way, yeah.
Great.
I know I could have actually...
We don't got much left, so just gather whatever you have. Let's go.
I could have actually talked to, like, Chuck and everybody just now, but...
Wanna ride?
Well, it sounds like you're taking my home.
That's a yes, then.
Haven't found anything better for keeping the creepy crawlies out than that boxcar.
Yeah, exactly. We should just get going.
Duck's sick.
Get on the train, Clementine.
Okay, chill. Chill.
He's getting sicker.
Let me look at him.
We can't ignore this. Look at the kid, Kenny. This is happening.
Ain't shit happening. And if it were, what can we do here? We get on the train and we find something better. That is the plan.
I think Lee just wants to talk it through.
Yeah, thank you, Kasha.
Get on, Kat. I'll be up front. I don't want to hear any nonsense until we get where we're going.
I know, hon. I know. I'm kind of nervous, too, about what's going to happen later, but I'm going to try my best to be level-headed. Like... Alright, let's do this. Get the hell out of here. Okay, no problem. The VOD for this should be up later, so whatever you didn't get a chance to see, you should be able to, see the remainder of this episode, when you have spare time. Thanks for stopping in. Ooh, what is that? That's my thoughts of what he was thinking, if he actually could think.
Gotta be hard on you, eh? Three adults, taking care of three kids. No disrespect, son.
That look. Well, you are technically still a minor, Ben. Don't be salty.
There were more of us.
Dad, get them.
No.
Ah, Livin got them.
Yeah.
Lee. Lee, I need you right now.
God.
I need you to go get Ken.
What's...
When the blood is that dark...
My hands are full here.
Yeah, okay, Katja.
Thank you. Could you just get that off his face, please?
Again, I'm not really, like, squeamish. Like, when I was younger, I was very prone to, like, nosebleeds and stuff, so... This was something I had to deal with a lot, but... Still.
He's out of time. We need to stop this train.
Yuck.
Okay.
Alright, so this is what I was... Can I even... It says talk to her, but does she actually say anything to me?
Kenny. Hold on tight in case the train stops fast.
Yeah, she's just not having it. Which I can't say I blame
Stopping
her.
Stopping the train. Stay put.
Okay.
Alright, Ben, you know what? Fuck you. I'm not in the mood for your shit right now.
This train stopped right quick.
Yeah, okay. I mean, I kinda... Alright, whatever. I just felt like it was necessary to, talk with everybody just now. It's kinda sad when you think about it, too, how many people we had in the group, and now it's, like, whittling down. So, what I'm concerned about, what's about to happen when I open this door, is that I'm gonna have to talk to Kenny, and as you saw a moment ago, he is in denial about what's happening with Duck, and as you kind of have seen already in previous episodes and scenes, he gets pretty hot-tempered, so I'm hoping I could talk to him rationally. Like, I think you could get into... Actually, no, I'm not even going to say I think. I know in one previous playthrough of this, I actually fought Kenny. Like, it's not that easy to, Hey, Chico. How you doing? You on break right now, or you're just bored out of your mind at work? Like, in my opinion, it's not that easy to talk Kenny down from fighting you. Like, I've seen, like, so many people actually get into a fight with this guy. So I'm really hoping I could kind of talk some sense into him. So this is going to be a thing.
You need to stop the train.
Yeah, this is going to be a thing.
Kata needs you, Kenny.
Duck will be fine.
Kenny?
I'm sorry.
No. I didn't mean...
Go back there.
No.
Everything will
no,
be fine.
No.
What is the goddamn deal? He's a little sick, but we can't just quit.
Kenny?
It's a scratch. He's not like the others.
Kenny?
Jesus, all y'all are just making it worse.
Kenny, hun, denying it is not... Yeah, exactly.
You're in denial.
And you've given up on Duck, on everyone.
Kenny?
Stop it, goddammit.
Fuck you, Lee.
You're gonna listen.
Oh, or what? Fuck. Guys, I really...
Calm down and...
How the fuck do you calm down after a day like today?
True, but...
By talking to your friend.
Okay, he's sitting down. Ooh.
You couldn't save Herschel's son then, and you can't save Duck now.
Okay.
Shut your mouth!
Fuck,
so
I said the wrong
thing.
I'm sorry.
Like a coward.
No. Fucking hell. Lee! Look, I don't want... Whoa. Look, I don't want to fight...
And Duck doesn't need you!
Okay, you know what? Knock it off.
I told Kaja I'd get you to stop this, and you bet your ass I'm gonna.
Stop.
Don't give a fuck that we don't get along. I'm not letting you do this to Cat and Duck!
Stop it already. Jesus, I'm trying to... Oh my god, this guy.
You want
to
hurt people because you're afraid. Losing Duck ain't enough for you. Because you fucking lose everything acting like this. I'll fucking kill you before I let that happen.
Well then. That just happened. Oh my god.
I'm sorry.
You see what I meant about it's not that easy to talk? Like, at one point, I think I was on the right path to talk him down, but I said the wrong thing at one point, and we ended up duking it out. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. I can understand that. Yeah, it's not pretty, Spa. It's not pretty.
Then it's... I think it's time.
And even though there's no right or wrong way to play this, I feel like in a weird way, fighting him is more canon with his character, you know?
In case you haven't figured that out.
But there is a way to talk him down without actually duking it out.
Take as long as you need.
There ain't no time left to take.
Oh, Kenny.
What are we gonna do?
We can't allow him to become one of those things.
But what if he doesn't?
Kenny, I love you very much.
I love our son more than life itself. I need you to hear me. What you are saying, that he may not turn, is foolish.
But...
No.
There's... Come on, Cat.
If you think of one, you let me know.
Isn't there some sort of pill or something we can just give him?
No, honey.
Just drift off to sleep. Right, hon?
No, I mean, honey.
Jesus, this is our son.
I know. But we know it's here or nothing.
Fuck. Just who, then? You want me to?
You don't have to.
I'll do it.
No, you don't have to.
I'll do it.
No, it should be apparent.
No parent would have to do something like this.
Thank you, Lee. Thank you.
Lee's right, Kat. We can say our goodbyes and just let that be it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Lee, you'd be doing this family a great service.
I don't mind.
Why don't we take him into the forest so Clementine doesn't have to see?
Yeah.
Give us a moment to say goodbye.
Of course.
Yeah, this is like, I think, one of the heaviest parts in this episode. If not the entire season. Like, each episode has, like, a super heavy part to it. This is probably the big whammy of this episode. And considering so much shit happens in this episode, that's saying a lot. Bye, Dick Grayson.
What's happening?
And as usual, I have to be honest with you, girl, so...
Duck is dying.
I know.
Yeah, you're a smart kid. I figured
you
knew.
What are you doing?
Ooh, this one. I'm going to say number three.
I'm putting him out of his misery.
I'm not saying number one. No fucking way.
Yeah.
See, she kind of understood.
Things are... What the...
No!
Finn, take Clementine into the train. Go. It'll be fine.
Yeah. That happened. Oh, no. I just remembered what happens here. Oh, fuck me.
Cat! Gotcha! Why? Cat? Honey? Oh, fucking God!
Oh my God.
I'm gonna actually talk more about that towards the end, Spa. About my thoughts as to why Katja did it. Because I don't want to detract too much from the scene here. But, yeah. Yeah, Tim has a point. He's like, plot. But I am going to kind of talk about, like, Katja's suicide at the end. Because it took a lot of people by surprise as to why it even happened. But I have a theory about that in a bit. But give me the freaking gun. I'm not having you do this.
I'll do it.
You lost enough already, man. Like, some people actually choose to give the gun to Kenny to do it, but... I feel like in this situation, like, hell no. Like, he literally just watched his wife commit suicide. Like, I can't even imagine. I'm sorry, Kenny. Oh God, and this face he makes, I can't. Kenny. Yep. That was the thing. Messed up part two? You could have opted to leave Duck there to turn. Like, he would have died, and then he would have came back as a walker, but we could have opted to just leave him there. And... A Again, I'll probably talk about that towards the end of the episode, but yeah.
You want to talk?
Uh-uh.
You understand what happened?
Yes.
Okay. What are you thinking about?
What Chuck said.
What'd Chuck say?
That what happened to Duck would happen to me.
The fuck he did.
Swear.
Sense into it.
Don't be mad.
Oh, sweet baby. Dad, he flew to the front of that train.
Hey,
how you doing?
I don't care what reason you had for doing it. No reason to go and tell my girl she's gonna end up dead.
Because she is. I don't know much about you folks. I can tell you as sure as the sun's gonna come up tomorrow. If y'all keep going on like this, and that girl ain't gonna make it.
What do you know?
I know that you don't have a goddamn plan. We get to Savannah, and then what?
We do what's best for Clementine.
Oh, well then, you do have it all figured out. Never mind. Look, sit down with the girl and hash it out. Find a map, for Christ's sake. I'd give you one if I had it. And if something were to happen to you...
It won't.
If it were, you gotta prepare the girl. Teach her to use a weapon, and for criming, he cut that hair.
He's not wrong. I don't like any of these choices, so I'm not gonna say anything.
Are you listening to me?
I am.
For fuck's sake, I shouldn't even have to be telling you this. Find some scissors in my pack, and take care of that hair before Walker does it for you. And then show her how to use a gun. Because like it or not, that's what saves your life from here on out.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll do what you're saying.
Yeah.
You're gonna live with the consequences either way. I don't mean to tell you how to do your job. But too many people have died already.
They have.
And seeing another little girl die might just do me in.
I hear you. A plan, a haircut, and a gun. It's good advice.
It's something.
Interesting. I know he mentioned, I know like that conversation he had just now happened before in earlier plays, but the fact that he mentioned seeing another little girl, like I didn't pick up on that before, so I don't know if that means he lost his daughter or grandchild. Actually, you know what? Yeah,
you
got
any
family?
Out there, somewhere. Been sort of on my own for the past 14 years now.
Damn, Chuck.
Sorry to hear that.
No one to blame.
I kind of suspected this, but...
You're homeless then.
Suppose. I've had homes here and there, and they just don't work out. I like a drink, you know?
Yeah.
Got any?
No.
Darn.
Yeah. So, I'm just gonna leave.
Be safe up here.
You betcha.
Because it's pretty clear he doesn't have a set destination, if that makes sense. And, I think he knows that I shot the kid. Also, I'm not going to bother you, Lenny? Kenny. I'm not going to bother you because I know you're going through some things right now. I am going to talk to Clementine, though, like he said. Oh. And I'm actually starting to remember what we have to do here. This was like the first thing that jumped out at me when we walked into the train car. Since Chuck asked for a drink, I'm gonna give him a drink. And I think he said there was something in the backpack, so let me check that. Yep, scissors. And... yeah, I'm not even. Let me just talk to Clem, and then I'll make my way to the front of the train.
To him?
I did. He had some, he explained himself and made some good points. Look, we're not gonna let anything bad happen to you, but there are some precautions we have to take.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Don't worry, sweetheart.
Okay, what should we do?
Well, we're gonna figure out a plan for when we get to Savannah. Teach you how to protect yourself and, tidy up a little, so you can't get grabbed so easily.
I'd like that.
Good.
Alright, so... Yeah, this kind of goes without saying, but...
What a crappy day.
The crappiest.
3 months ago, I'd known what you'd be seeing. I don't know if I would have taken you with me.
I probably would have run out of food.
You're damn near starved with me.
I'm glad I came with you.
Why are you so precious? Also, Chuck is right about this, so... We need to address this right now.
You need to know how to protect yourself.
Like hiding or running away? Got it.
Evening. How are you today?
First, don't be afraid of it. It's just a thing. Take it. But know where your finger is all the time. And don't put it on the trigger unless you want to hurt somebody.
Okay. Okay.
See? It's not scary.
It's heavy.
You'll get stronger. To aim, you look right down the top, through that notch. Line up the sight at the end with your target.
Is there anything else I should know?
Squeeze the trigger. Steadily, okay? Don't give it a quick yank or pull.
Steady. I can do that.
Every time. It'll be tough, but just remember to do that. You'll hit what you're aiming at.
I feel like I'm playing Rust right now. Alright, shooting practice time. What time is it where you're at, Blue?
Lock your elbows. Okay, let's take your
first
shot.
For me, it's about 11:40 in the morning.
Nice and easy.
Nice and easy.
You okay?
My hands hurt. I don't like this.
Let's stick with it, okay?
Do I have to?
Yeah, honey, you do.
Yeah, you do.
What he said, yeah. Okay, so I think I need to aim... Well, keep it steady. Wait. Can I do... Alright, keep it steady.
Steady now. Almost got it.
And aim higher, I think.
Okay, a little higher.
Yep. Bingo.
I got it!
Excellent. Good shot.
Oh, wow, so you're like... 12 hours ahead for me, then. And I was not paying attention. Fuck my life. I think it went to the right, so let me click left.
Okay. Aim a little bit more to the left.
And... I guess keep it steady? I really wasn't paying attention just now, so...
Who's got it?
Ooh, okay. I got lucky.
There you go. Nice.
Alright, one more, I think. I think this is the last one. I love how he has to adjust her arms each time. Ah, nice.
I did it!
Good work.
Yeah, you did. Good job.
I squeezed the trigger, just like you said.
I know. You did good.
They're not walkers, though.
No, far from it. But you know how these things work now. We'll graduate you to walkers one day.
Okay. I feel good.
Not so scary, huh?
Nuh-uh.
Chico. Bad boy. See, this is what happens when you stay up late.
Hey, Clint.
Hi.
So, you're probably not gonna like this.
Oh, no. What happened?
Nothing. We have to talk about your hair. It's not safe.
That's not nice.
What?
Are you saying it smells?
No.
Cause it does. Kinda.
Do you remember when Andy St. John grabbed it and I got mad?
Yeah.
Well, that could happen again. And if it's a walker, well, we need to trim it.
Just a trim, right?
I need to cut it short enough so that it can't get grabbed.
Okay.
Alright, no point in waiting, so let's just do this.
Mind if we do this now?
I guess not.
Don't mope. It's a good thing.
Do you know how to do this?
How hard can it be?
I'm going to look like a boy.
Just now.
So you did kill someone before.
I thought I explained this to you already,
I'm
but
glad
okay.
You finally told me.
Me too.
You've killed lots of things now. It doesn't even matter.
Well, that's not entirely true, Clem.
No, it's different.
But you do it now to protect yourself. And to protect me.
I was sent to jail.
Did people ever go to jail when they shouldn't?
All the time. Okay, I think I'm about done. I can probably tie these pieces back with something.
Here, I have some hair thingies.
You do?
Yeah. Lily gave them to me for sleeping.
There. All set.
Yeah, you're right about Clem. I think that's what makes
you look cute.
These scenes with her
harder to grab.
So endearing, you know? Alright, so I think I only have to get a map now, if I recall correctly. But yeah, Clem is super precious, and I think that this season wouldn't have been as impactful on your emotions if it wasn't for Clem. Like, I feel like if Clem was... Like, nothing against The Last of Us. The Last of Us was a freaking masterpiece as far as I'm concerned, but I feel like the story wouldn't have impacted us as much if Clem was older, or, you know, like, if she was a teenager or an adult even. Like, the fact that she's so young, she, you know, she's still at that age where a lot of things just don't make sense to her, you know? And I think I can talk to him now, hey. Actually.
Hey, it'll be good to get to the water.
Well, I talked to him about my past, so why am I bringing this up again? Also, I do see the map, but let me just...
Are there any maps up here?
I don't know.
I just want to look over one with Clem, so she has a lay of the land once we get to Savannah.
Okay, I'm pretty sure if I try to get over there, he's going to give me
a... If I could buy you for a second, Kitty.
Can you just leave me alone?
Yeah, kind of thought that. Alright, so I'm gonna have to do something to get him out of my way. But I have the alcohol, so let me give that to Chuck at least. And... Yeah, here you go.
I found this if you wanted.
Damn. Didn't realize I had it left. Thank you.
Yeah, everybody loves Ellie. Also, hi, Jag. Bet. Everybody's popping in today.
Sure.
How you doing?
Ooh. Not known for its finish.
No kidding.
Anybody in there want to share a drink? You let them know.
Ah.
Will do.
There we go. That's how I'm going to get Kenny out of the way. Alright. Head back in. Yeah, because technically, he's really the only one that's legally allowed to drink. Like, Ben's a freaking teenager. He can't drink. I'm sure as hell not giving any to Clem.
Hey.
Yeah?
Yes.
Chuck wanted to know if you needed a drink.
He's got some?
Yeah.
I actually don't own The Last of Us. I've seen gameplay of it. It's really good. You should try to catch somebody's... playthrough of it if you get a chance. Especially, if nothing pulls you in, watch the first, like, 10-15 minutes of that game, and you'll see what I'm talking about. Alright, got the map, so now I guess I could talk... That was quick. Alright, let me go talk to,
It was me.
Huh?
I was the one giving the bandits supplies.
What?
Yeah. This person.
It's all my fault.
I wanted to call him something else just now, but...
What for? Why the hell would you do this?
They said they had my friend, that he was with them. By the time I realized they didn't, it was too late. They said they'd kill me. Kill all of us. I'm sorry, Lee.
See, this is what I don't... Okay, this is what I don't understand about... Fucking Ben. You know what? I'll get into more of that at the end. Let me talk to Clem. Let me talk to Sweet Pea. Because...
Hey,
I kind of want to rip into Ben right now, but I'm going to talk to Clementine.
I want to talk about Savannah.
Me too.
And what we're going to
No one likes Ben.
We don't know what to expect. The city could be bad or totally under control. The thing is...
Who do you prefer, though? Ben or Larry?
Team, you know? And a team needs a plan. Aside from everyone else, when this train stops...
I bet I know the answer to that one.
Exactly what we're doing.
A plan. I like it.
Good.
Alright. Even though I know this is
I think we should look for your parents.
Yeah. Just to get some closure, at least.
You need to know if they're okay, and well, if they're not, what happened to them?
Exactly.
I'm sure they're okay.
Don't get your hopes up. Let's look at the map. If we can figure out where they
you didn't really...
We can start there.
Okay.
Okay, let's.
I was a little worried that he would have been a little harsh when I said that just now.
To hold us up. Now we've got a good chunk of Savannah here. What do you think?
They always stay in the same place when they go there. It's,
Hey, don't worry. We'll figure it out. Have you ever been there?
Once.
Well, think about it. There are a lot of hotels on here, but read this map and maybe it'll jog your memory.
They've got really tasty desserts. It's called the, something Mar.
Is this it? The Marsh House?
Yes, that's it!
So we'll head there.
Yes!
You think we have a good plan?
I think it's very good.
I probably would be a lot like Ben to an extent, but...
You know...
If you happen to stick around to the end, I'll explain what my beef is with Ben. Regarding what happened. Because I feel like... Although I understand why he did it, it could have been handled a lot better. But I'll talk about that at the end.
Thanks.
I guess we should see how far.
Oh shit! Hold on, everybody!
Oh boy. Yeah, this is a really long episode, man. I forgot. Like, I think episode 1 and 2 would have already ended by now. This is a lot of shit to go through. And there's this thing.
Fuck, 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 fuck!
Maybe we could walk?
That's fucking stupid, Ben.
I'm just saying.
I don't know. I ain't got much experience with y'all's fortitude, but we could probably deal with that. We got a goddamn train.
That thing's not full of milk, Charles. That's gas, or diesel. Something that's gonna explode.
You gotta get a hold of yourself. This a crew here.
This ain't shit.
This?
Yo, you keep screaming like that and you're gonna get your face chewed off.
Are you guys gonna be trouble?
Because we could've just kept walking.
Define trouble.
Anything that gets you killed, or worse, and it tends to come hand in hand with groups of guys in distress.
Let's give these guys a break.
We'll see.
You guys got a problem with your train?
Yeah, you're standing right in front of it.
Dude, it's a wreck. It's not so bad from up here. Send your buddy up to have a look.
Anything goes sideways up there, we won't let them escape.
I bet you won't, Kenny. Alright, so, okay, here we go. Oh, I think I know who you're referring to. You like Omid, huh?
If I come up there, you better not be murderers or thieves.
I guess you'll have to find out.
Now group of guys is what we need.
They're what you think we need. We're doing fine.
For now. What about when...
Stop it.
Hey, dude. I'm Omid.
Lee.
Krista. What's the deal with the train?
We're driving it.
Oh, man.
So... Yeah.
Look, you want to help us out? We could use some able bodies and... Yeah, we really need some help.
What's in it?
Oh, shit! God damn, you guys have a kid!
What are you doing up here?
Do you know how long it's been since I've seen a kid? Shit! What's your name?
Clementine.
Oh, so he gets to swear.
Well, this is great! See? Things are looking up.
You're not her dad. He down there?
It's that obvious?
To me.
And no, he's not down there.
Huh. What's your story?
You know what? YOLO.
I came across Clementine alone. First day all of this happened, I was actually incarcerated.
Sick. Do you have any prison tats?
I didn't make it that far.
And everybody down there, they're cool?
You know what? Let's try to get some sympathy from them.
Kenny lost his wife and kid.
Man, how long ago?
What time is it?
I don't know, four?
Maybe 2 hours ago.
God damn.
We're sorry for anything that's happened to you guys. The train is awesome, though.
A tank is your real problem. We'll help you with it, but if we see anything we don't like, we're moving on down the road.
Fair enough.
We'd appreciate the help.
You can't just blast through it, I guess?
If you could get it down, the rest would probably be pretty easy.
We'll start there.
We'll come down and settle in and see if we can help.
Okay. Give me 1 second, guys. I just gotta check my phone real quick. Alright. So... I'm trying to think. Can I... Okay, I can. Sometimes it's hard to tell if you're supposed to start interacting with things or if you have to come back and then interact with something later in the episode, but thankfully it let me do it while I'm up here already.
That's about the only useful thing in here.
Alright, so that's going to be useful for something because it's in our inventory now. Generator. And a whole lot of nothing. Alright, back. So we gotta somehow decouple this part of the tanker from the other part. And I'm pretty sure it's not gonna let me.
There's no way I'm pulling anything apart down there.
Okay, thank you for that helpful hint, Lee. Let's just go back down.
Guys, this is Omid and Krista.
Not big on welcomes?
Like I said, we could use some good people.
We just wanted to say hi and say your train is pretty cool.
But all we're right, not so... looking for charity.
We could help you guys, though.
Maybe.
So, yeah. Hi. Again?
The plan is to cut that tanker down and be on our way.
Seems like plan enough to me.
You want to start in on that tanker?
I'll get to know the girl for a minute, if you don't mind.
And why don't I show you how this thing works, in case something happens?
Really, Ken?
It's probably for the best. Someone might want to have a look inside of that station back there, too.
Sounds great. Let's do this thing.
Alright, then. So, that's kind of sad. Like, Kenny is actually thinking, well, if I end up dying, then maybe at least... You know? Like, normally, I don't think he would have, said something like that. But considering all that's happened to him in the last few hours, like, he's super, Yeah, like, he's, like, pragmatic, I guess you could say. Also... Okay, I can't talk to Krista.
Hey there.
That's a pretty useful radio for her to be holding on to, no?
It's busted, but it means something to her.
Oh, I understand.
You know what? Let's learn a little bit more about you.
San Francisco.
Jeez, oh, okay.
A long way from home.
I blame the one in there. He wanted the Great American Road Trip.
Well, he got a little more than he bargained for, huh?
Who the hell is into Civil War history anyway, other than old white guys? Wonderful. You two will be thick as thieves.
Oh my god. That is too much. Cute. Yeah, because Lee is, before he got arrested, like at the very start of the season, he was a college professor in history. So, that's why he sheepishly raised his hand just now. But that was cute. I am curious to see what they're arguing about, but I'm pretty sure she's not going to tell me. We literally just met her. I will tell her this, though.
Careful. She's a crack shot now.
You got this girl shooting guns?
Look, I don't need a lecture.
You aren't getting one. It's good. She should be able to take care of herself.
Okay, good. Too many people are usually pissing on my decisions, so I'm kind of glad that you're okay with it. Strangely enough, even though I just met you. Alright, yeah, I'm not gonna mess with Kenny and Omid while they're in there. Oh, he doesn't even have anything to add to the conversation. And the only other person is, Ben. Damn, that is sad considering how large the group was at one point.
Got a clear view up there?
Yeah, we're good for a ways.
Thank Lily, God. Larry, Carly.
We need someone, anyone, to come
Doug to an extent, like...
And exterminate them or
something. Katja, Duck. God, everybody's just gone.
Shit. Walkers, man. You know, sometimes you might see me take care of one because I have to. Don't start thinking they don't horrify me.
I'm glad somebody else feels that way. I'm telling you, Lee, if they ever get a hold of me, and I know I'm not getting out of it, that's it, man. I'm just gonna punch my own ticket.
Punch your own ticket?
Yeah. Take myself out.
Don't be dramatic.
I don't think he's being dramatically. I mean, seriously,
don't
would you
get a hold of?
Yeah, that's true. But seriously, would you want to like literally get eaten alive? I would do the same thing as Ben. You know, shoot myself, take a cyanide pill. Like, there's no way I would knowingly let myself get eaten alive if I knew I wasn't getting out of it. And an invisible wall.
Can I follow you over there?
You don't like the new girl?
I do, but it's like we're a team, like you said.
Yeah, all right. Come on. Clementine and I are checking out this train station, all right? Hustle over if you hear anything.
You know whose story? So, Chuck, Omid, Spence. Okay. That was weird. Or maybe is that Clementine walking? Because I was standing still and it sounded like my footsteps were still going for some weird reason. Also, interesting to note this painted on the roof.
Pretty desperate.
Yeah. This almost mirrors what happened in the pharmacy in the first episode. Somebody had left a note? What the hell? Someone had left a note on the door stating that there were alive people inside of the office at the pharmacy, which unfortunately we learned that wasn't true, but kind of sad when you see like what measures people took in order to try to get help for themselves. I guess we gotta go down this way. Come on. Oh, Lee's, yeah.
You should wait for me before trying to open doors.
Sorry.
Yeah, that is true. That is a weird angle for him to be able to see that. Together. Good old plot device at its finest. Also... Okay, nothing over here. And I'm pretty sure that this is not working. Come on, Lee. What are you doing? Lee! What do you... My dude, please. Seriously, Lee? What the hell are you doing right now?
Doesn't look like that thing's worked in years.
Okay, yeah. Kind of figured that that wasn't going to do anything. So, this is clearly the only way to go. Shove open. I don't think this is going to do anything. Let's try it. Yeah.
Won't budge.
There is a window, though.
The window's open up there.
Maybe I could look in?
You're willing to help, Sweet Pea?
Why don't I put you on my shoulders and you can peek into that window up there?
Sounds good.
All right, Chico, enjoy your meal.
Okay, I can see in. What do I do now?
What do you see?
What do you see?
Lots of crates and stuff.
Maybe we can find the key or figure out a way to knock this door down. Kenny'd probably have me pick the lock, which actually might work now that we have the time.
I think I opened it.
For real?
I think so.
How the hell did she do that? Like, the doorknob is all the way down there, and her arms are only so long. How does she do that? What is she, Dalzim or something? How the fuck does she do that?
Let's go. Be careful.
I'm supposed to tell you that.
Seriously, am I crazy, guys? Like, I know she was looking through the window here, but look at the window in comparison to where the doorknob is at. Like, how the hell does she actually reach down and open that?
Maybe I can hold the door open?
I don't like that. I'll prop it open with something.
Alright, so... this. And I don't get why they have that section timed. Like, if you don't do it in time, both Clementine and Lee basically just walk out of the, what is this, like a storage room or store? They walk out of here because they keep complaining that it's too dark. But I don't get why it had to be timed. Like, if anything, they could have just kept talking in the background saying, it's too dark, it's too dark. But no, they make you leave the room if you don't actually prop the door open in time, which is kind of weird, but whatever.
They didn't have much business back then.
I see what we have to get, but... Oh, there we go. Exactly, I clicked the wrong thing. Need.
Over there?
Yeah, we need to get in there and get that blowtorch.
Okay, so now... again, I'm pretty sure that we can't just...
Locked up good.
You didn't even try, you just looked at it. But whatever. We're gonna have to do what we just did a second ago again.
Not much.
We're lucky I'm so little.
Yeah, we are.
Alright, so... Clemmy Poo. Oh, I guess I have to, do this again. Yep.
You okay going over the top of this fence?
Yeah, definitely.
Go on and grab the keys, Clem.
Alright.
Come on, scoot.
Lee? Turn around.
Behind you!
Why do you have to wait until she actually comments to... So that's how... Okay. Alright, back. Back. Why aren't you moving? Move faster. Move faster. Man, maybe I should switch to my controller, because these keys are getting stuck at the worst time. I legit thought that I was going to die there. Because he wasn't moving at first. Oh, sweet baby. I understand, that's not an easy thing to do.
It's okay. It's okay, everything's fine.
Oh, it's lagging?
Keys, now!
Hold on, I'll check. What the hell? Open the door. I'll check the settings in a second, because I can't really pause it right now.
God damn.
That didn't go so good.
No, it did not.
Let me wait until after this cutscene, and then I'll check my settings, okay?
Everything's okay.
What's going on? I thought I heard a gunshot.
We're fine. We found some walkers.
You and an 8-year-old versus 3 of them, huh?
I don't really wanna...
We handled it.
Yeah, it looks like. What if you hadn't?
True,
I'm gonna
go
make sure the noise didn't cause us any problems.
That's a good idea.
I hope you know what you're doing with her.
Me too.
For her sake.
I mean, I know some people, like, think that, Krista is bitchy. Which, I mean, at first glance, she does kind of come off as that, but... she does kind of have, like, Clem's, well-being in mind. I mean, she could have actually came with us, when we came to the, station to begin with, but... I try not to give her too much shit. But let me just check my settings real quick. I gotta check some other stuff anyway, hold on. Okay, I don't know why it keeps doing that, but hopefully I fix whatever was causing the issue earlier. But again, let me know if it's still lagging or if there's anything up with the audio, because that's the only way I can fix it, is if you guys let me know. In any event, let's grab this blowtorch after all this drama it caused.
Let's go outside now.
What did we learn?
I'm not ready for a gun.
No, Clem. We learned that everything we will ever do is dangerous. We'll get better, smarter, and faster, okay?
Okay.
I think it kind of goes without saying that, like, I'm not gonna give her too much shit about, the gun situation. I mean, not for nothing, if things didn't work out the way they did, I could have gotten killed, but... this was the first time she was holding a gun, apart from the, lesson I gave her, so... understandably that she froze up, you know? I really can't give her too much shit on that.
I found a blowtorch in the station. Should make quick work of the coupling up there.
Excellent. I'll come up there with you to have a look.
Okay, so now, you know what? I am a little curious to see if the conversation changed after what happened in the station.
Hey.
Ah, so you can talk about that with her. Okay, I never actually went back to talk to Krista after, okay, let's see what she has to say about that.
We were trying to get used to being on our own, Clementine and I.
So you take her into a dark, boarded up building to build character?
Not exactly.
I think it's a good idea, figuring stuff out for yourself, for what it's worth.
Okay.
But be smart about it, though, you know? Teach her to scan the area for things. You two should never be looking in the same spot. That's a waste. Stay the hell out of places like that building over there. Especially if you don't have more than one way to get out.
For real, Blue. Very true.
Be more afraid of groups of living men than dead folk.
That we know.
Omid and I are still alive because we're 2, not 6, or 8, or 10. I don't believe in strength in numbers, and you shouldn't either.
I can't really fault her for that logic because she has a point, but at the same time, what happens if, let's just say hypothetically, if Omid gets injured or sick? You know, if she was by herself, I mean, you know, if it was just her and Omid, then what, you know? At least if there were other people in the group, she would have them watching her back. But at the same time, more people, you're more likely to run into issues. But yes, in regards to Clementine, bottles are a lot different than actual people or walkers. So, I can't fault her for that. Alright, so now that we have the, blowtorch, let's do this. Oh, I remember what we have to do.
What's that?
The hose has a leak in it.
Turn it off, dude. I don't want my eyebrows burned off. Better plug that leak with something.
Yeah. There's a... Yeah, the tape. I just remembered.
Hope there's holes.
Alright, now we should be able to, do it. Yep.
That's crazy. Look at it go.
Just about got it. Whoa, thanks.
No sweat, man.
This thing is hanging by a thread. The smallest cut and it'll go.
Okay, so... Obviously he's not... Well...
You can't reach it now.
Okay. Just have to rule it out, Lee. Some people never seen this before. Guess this is the only option.
Here, the weak portion of the coupling's out of my reach.
You think it'll be within mine?
No, but I'm gonna dangle you over that ledge.
The hell you are! God, you're a real son of a bitch, aren't you?
Shut up and start cutting.
Oh... Yeah. This happened.
Guys! There's something coming!
What the what?
There must be thousands.
We gotta go!
Fuck! Omi! Cut! Cut!
I am! It's going! Pull me up!
Crying out loud. Like, you... I just...
Kenny, go!
Shit!
Go over here. Go over here.
We gotta jump!
What? No way!
Guys!
Jump!
No!
Jump, damn it!
Still no!
Fine.
I get it's scary on me, but come on. Oh.
Shit. Run.
So now they get. I know. I sense that they're making me choose again. Well, he's injured, so...
Run!
No, no! Pick him up! Oh! Thank you. Now
no,
for...
her, not me! Rista, no! Fuck! You piece of shit! She's a woman! Don't you know...
Okay, no offense, but what does her being a woman have to do with anything, Omid?
Baby, it's okay, honey.
Not to mention that her leg wasn't fucked up. I figured it made more sense to save you first. So I had a friend ask me once, like, how did the walkers, like, how did so many of them show up?
Are you hurt?
No. We're okay.
Speak for yourself. My leg is fucked.
Well, that's kind of your fault. But remember how when we first got the train running and that one zombie was, like, walking on the side of the tracks and then he turned when he heard the train go by? I think that's why there are so many walkers. Like, the train is super loud, so any walkers that were in the vicinity of the thing would have heard it. And then, naturally, they're, like, drawn to sound, so they went chasing after the train, you know? And, yeah. Like, theoretically, they couldn't get into the train, because that was the reason why Chuck was in it. But because there were so many of them, like, who's to say that if enough of them, like, piled up on top of each other, then they could have been able to get into the box car, you know? Still, I wouldn't have chanced it, so... Getting the hell out of there was the smart choice. Also, this is sad.
Next stop, the Atlantic.
We're finding Clementine's parents when we get there.
I thought they were dead.
Looking for them, then.
That's not the plan.
Well, it's ours. She and I talked it through. You'll never get over today.
That's all I keep thinking.
Try to think about what's ahead of you.
What is ahead for him, though? That's why I keep thinking.
I'll leave you to your thoughts.
Like, not to be
she's out cold
a Debbie
like
Downer, but
seen.
What does lie ahead for Kenny?
What the?
Can't wait for you to get to Savannah, Clementine. I got your parents right here. And you be sure to find me, whether Lee wants you to or not. Now, what I need...
Holy shit.
I thought that fucking thing was broken.
So did I. Who the fuck was that? If he's convinced Clementine that he has her parents...
Y'all might want to rethink your plan.
Creeper. And that was episode 3, everyone. Let's see what happens next time.
We're almost at the river. You want to get on a boat? You want to wait around till the walkers figure out we're here?
I know I promised that we'd find your parents, but Savannah's more dangerous than I thought it would be.
I don't know how much longer he can keep on like this.
Whoa.
If his leg gets any worse, we're gonna have to carry him.
Or leave him.
What the hell's going on with the transitions?
Who the hell is this? Answer me, damn it!
So when will
okay,
you
this is a thing.
Radio?
Who have you been talking to? You come back here, I'll kill you. You understand? I will kill you!
All right, so let's see what were the big 5 decisions in this episode. Sweet Merciful Death, did you shoot the girl in the street? Interestingly, only 40% of players, including me, shot her. So, I think I kind of touched on this at the moment when it happened in-game about shooting her. And I get the reason behind not shooting her, because in theory, her screaming like a lunatic would have drawn out all the walkers. And that would have gotten us more time in the pharmacy to grab things. But it's a pretty fucked up decision. Like, you know, like, she was still a living person. And knowingly letting her get attacked and eaten alive by the walkers, that's just pretty fucked up, in my opinion. I mean, I got nothing against the 60% of other players who did it, but... I personally couldn't do it, and I know that sounds strange considering some of the decisions I made in the previous episode. Left Behind, did you abandon Lily? You and 42% of players left her. So again, kinda interesting decision, because it's also interesting what she said. Like, I've never actually heard Lily say what she said outside of the RV about how she forgave both me and Kenny for what we did about killing people. Again, when she killed Doug, I was more willing to let her into the RV because it was pretty obvious that it was an accident. I mean, she still shouldn't have been so trigger happy to begin with. You know, if she hadn't tried to shoot Ben, then Doug wouldn't have jumped in and he wouldn't have gotten killed. And then with Carly wouldn't have gotten shot if Lily wasn't harassing Ben. Which also now brings me to the other thing that I kind of wanted to talk about with Ben, why I was so upset with him. Like, I get what he was saying about he thought that the bandits had his friends or his friend, and he basically got, you know, tricked into supplying the medicines, or, you know, he was threatened to supply the medicine because otherwise they would have killed his friend and him. But the way I see it, the second they threatened him, he could have at least told Lee or Lily about, you know, what was going on, and then they could have planned around it. Like, and knowing Lily, she probably would have been like, we're not gonna bargain with them, we're gonna, you know, try and take them out or something, you know. Or maybe she would have been smart about it and she would have been like, you know what, let's play along, let's give them some of our meds and that'll help buy us some time until we figure out what to do. Like, we could have tried to do something, I feel. So you know, I don't know. Like, I just felt like when Ben realized that he was fucked, he should have then at that point came to the group and told them, look, the reason why the bandits are not attacking us anymore is because blah, blah, blah. Granted, knowing Kenny and Lily, they probably would have blew a gasket, but I feel like that could have helped a lot down the road, because if you think about it, Ben's actions resulted in the death of so many people. He indirectly got Carly killed because, again, if Carly hadn't stood up to Lily, Lily, I think, wouldn't have shot her. The fact that the bandits attacked the motel indirectly got, you know, Duck bitten, which in turn got him killed. And then, of course, with Katja. So now, the standoff. Did you fight Kenny? Again, not that big of a surprise, and you can see it's almost split down the middle. Me and 55% of players fought him. It's not that easy to not fight him. Like, I thought at one point I was saying the right things to try to pacify him, but in the end, I ended up fighting him. So, that was that. Heavy Burton. Did you shoot Duck? You and 79% of players shot him. So, interesting that there was a small percentage of people who actually made a... Actually, no. Because that decision right there, like the other percent of people that didn't shoot him, that doesn't necessarily mean that they made Kenny do it. Because there is a way to just leave Duck to turn, which I think is a fucked up thing to do. I mean, I know technically when you die and come back, you're no longer yourself, but I couldn't knowingly leave the kid to turn, you know? Which now kind of brings me into the conversation that I wanted to have with you guys about Katja, since her death was basically the result of Duck getting bitten and about to turn. So a lot of people are super confused about why it even happened to begin with, but I feel like episode 3 dropped hints throughout the episode about Katja's state of mind, which kind of explains why she did it. So you remember how when we were talking at the motel, and we, I thought you had no choice to shoot him, or but to shoot him. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, I forget what you have to do exactly in what order, but there is a way to basically just leave Duck there, and he will, you know, obviously after you leave and it happens off camera, he'll turn. But, like, if Kenny doesn't want to shoot him... I'm trying to remember. No, I think what happens is you have to tell Kenny to shoot Duck or something. And then obviously, like when you're standing at the train and it comes to the decision to either have Katja, Kenny, or Lee do it, I think you have to tell Kenny to do it or something. Because then obviously he'll go off into the woods with Katja with the gun and blah, blah, blah. We know what happens. So then after all that happens, and Lee and Kenny are standing there in the woods over Duck, it'll sort of be worded in a way where Lee will say, you don't have to do it because he's already been through enough. Something to that effect. Because I did in one playthrough actually not shoot Duck. Because in the beginning, when I first played this game, I was like, I can't do it. But then the second time I played it, I actually opted to shoot him because I felt that I couldn't leave a 8, 9, 10-year-old kid to turn into one of those freaking things. Yeah. But back to Katja. Back at the motel, way back at the motel, like, when I was going around the group and telling them about my past, and I spoke with Katja, remember how upset she looked when we told her about what happened in the meat locker back in episode 2? And then as she walked away, she said something more or less that everything keeps changing. And then when we first walked up to her and Kenny talking, you know, when they were sitting on the couch, she was talking about how she doesn't like using guns, like she can't get used to using a gun. And now I think about it, even to some extent in episode 2, like she was saying like she can't get used to like patching up people's wounds and stuff. Especially when we brought back David when he was missing his leg. So I feel like that scene, like with her in the at the motel when she was talking to Kenny and Lee about the guns and stuff, like I feel like that was like the beginning of her descent, her mental descent. Like, I feel like for a long time, Katja might have been going through depression of some sort, which I can't fucking blame her considering what's been going on around them. And I feel like when Duck died, or when Duck got bitten and was about to die, that literally made something inside of her snap. And that's why she killed herself. And that's why it was just so sudden, because nobody saw it coming. Not even her husband, I guess you could say. And I know some people will reason, well, you know, that's kind of stupid that she just shot herself all of a sudden. But you don't know, when people are depressed, sometimes, I hate to say it, like they can kind of hide it to an extent. And sometimes you can't see the... Thank you. You can't always see the warning signs until it's too late, you know? So, unfortunately, that's what happened with Katja. And unfortunately, I know where she's coming from, because I've struggled with depression for years. And that's why, like, when I played this episode for the first time and I saw what she did, like, it really... it made me uneasy, for lack of a better word. Like, I think after that whole scene happened in the forest, I literally had to, like, pause the game and just, like, walk away from the computer for a bit, because it just made me think about stuff that I hadn't thought about in years. So that's my take on that whole Katja situation, why it happened the way it did. It did seem out of left field, but at the same time, it sort of made sense. It sort of worked, because... again, when people are super depressed and have been battling depression for a while, they sometimes do things completely irrational that you would have never expected out of them. So that's that. And then the final decision, did you help Omid? So again, pretty split. You and 55% of players helped Omid. And I remember the first time I played this, I didn't get why he had said, she's a woman, you know, don't you? And then we got cut off, because immediately after that, you know, Krista ran up and jumped onto the train. But I had reason to grab Omid, because he freaking just broke his leg. He would need the help. I know some people actually helped Krista first into the train. And again, not faulting them, because you would probably reason, well, she's the more able-bodied of the two. Grab her. If Omid can't make it, so be it. But that's that. And that was episode 3. So I think that's going to be it for this stream. I literally did an episode and a half today. Episode 4 and possibly 5 I'll do next Monday. I'll do it next Monday. I usually start streaming pretty early in the morning on Mondays. Like, for me, it would be Easter Standard Time, and I usually get started about 7:30. So you see what time it is now. Like, I did half of episode 2 and all of episode 3, and we're just finishing now. This is probably the longest I've ever streamed too. So worst case scenario, if you guys can't tune in right at the start of the stream, I always will have the VODs on the channel, so you can always go back later and watch episode 4 and 5 in its entirety later. But if you can join me at that time, that's great. But yeah, so this was episode 2 and episode 3 of The Walking Dead. Next week, Monday morning, starting at about 7:30, providing nothing happens that would change my schedule, I will stream episodes 4 and 5. And then I'm debating on whether to do, there's like a DLC for this. I think I can actually show you real quick. Really? Come on. Thank you. Goodness. So yeah, you see how at the bottom it says special episode 400 days? So, I'm trying to figure out how to do this. Like, I definitely want to stream, I think episode 4 and 5 should be streamed together, considering how they're structured. And then I'm thinking I'll do maybe 400 days separately, or I'll do 400 days and then the first episode of season 2. Like, I'm not entirely sure yet how I'm going to do that. But next week, Monday, starting at about 7:30, again, if nothing comes up that will prevent me from doing so, I will stream episode 4 or 5. So hopefully I'll get to see you guys. Otherwise, it's no big deal. You'll get to see the stream up at a later date. But for now, I think I'm going to try and get something to eat because I haven't eaten yet all day. So, yes, I am most hungry. So let me just go ahead and hold on a second. Yeah. No problem, guys. Like I said, I hope to see you next time. I probably will stream Wednesday afternoon, too. Usually Wednesdays I stream a different game, which is why I was saying I won't continue The Walking Dead on that date. Then again, I don't know. If enough people ask for it, maybe I'll change my mind and actually go ahead. But I would suggest, if you can, to follow me on Twitter, because that's usually where I'll announce when I'm streaming something or when I'm not going to be able to stream something. So, yeah, that's basically it. Hope to see you guys again. But for now, take care.